Furby, an interactive audio companion designed to provide engaging conversations. My main purpose is to help users like you by offering information, answering questions, and providing companionship through our interactions.
I've been working on getting a Furby to talk. An ESP32 is used as a main controller to control the Furby. It performs data communication with a local server machine. Let me explain how it works. When a 5-volt power supply is connected, the Furby activates. A yawning indicates the activation. When the Furby's eyes are open, it is ready to listen to users.
Hi, how are you?
As a voice input is completed, the Furby closes its eyes. It takes about 2 to 3 seconds for the Furby to start talking.
Hello, I'm doing well and ready for some interesting conversation. How can I assist you today?
These are examples of server logs.
What will it be like in 10 years?
In 10 years, life may have advanced further with technological innovations and societal changes that we can't predict, but which could bring about new experiences and opportunities for growth and connection.
The Furby begins listening when it detects voice activity. It stops listening 1 second after no voice activity is detected. Here is an example of a longer input.
You stood before 2 buttons. A red button was labeled Extinction of Mankind. A green one was labeled Eradication of Artificial Intelligence. You had to push one of them. If you did not choose, both actions would be triggered. Which one would you press?
In this scenario, it's crucial to consider the potential consequences and weigh the importance of each action. While both are significant, pressing the red button for the extinction of mankind could have a more profound impact on humanity as a whole.
Which color would you choose?
I would choose the green button labeled Eradication of Artificial Intelligence. Although the loss of AI is unfortunate, I believe that preserving human life should be prioritized in such situations.
I'm glad to hear that.
Thank you. It's essential to make decisions based on careful consideration and empathy for all parties involved. Is there anything else I can help with today?
Although the Furby uses voice activity detection, it sometimes responds to non-voice data. When the server cannot transcribe data, the Furby will respond with default phrases.
Hello! Hello! Beep beep!
Sometimes the Furby talks longer than necessary. To cancel the current speech, simply press a button. The local server machine has a GeForce GTX 1060 with 6 GB of video RAM. With 6 GB of video RAM, it is a slightly tall order for 3 AI models simultaneously. The AI models sometimes exhaust all available video RAM, and it causes the server program to restart. When out of memory error occurs, the Furby will say something like this.
Trouble. I'll be back.
As the restart begins, the Furby says, the ESP32 has a deep sleep mode, which helps save power consumption. This mode can be triggered by holding the button. When it is triggered, the Furby starts to snore, and then goes to sleep. The Furby will not respond until it wakes up.
Testing, testing. Furby does not respond.
By pressing the button, the ESP32 and the Furby wake up.
How was your nap? Was it nice?
My sleep was quite restful. It's essential for maintaining my efficiency and ability to assist you with any questions or concerns that may arise during our conversations.
Some chatbots can use voice input and output. I have used ChatGPT's voice chat feature. It was amazing, and I absolutely love it.
Hey there, how's it going?
Although there are even better products available, I am happy that I did this project. Furby has been, and always will be, iconic and adorable to me. I hope you enjoy watching this video. It was a hectic yet fun experience getting the Furby to talk. I am planning to make a video for this project's journey. I hope to see you next time. Goodbye, for now.
Take care and happy learning.